Oh, thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Shalom. The Lord bless you. I welcome you in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. The Bible says God is faithful by whom we were called to the fellowship of his Son, Jesus Christ. The title of this particular prophetic word says, you are in between two men who are madly in love with you. I say it again. The title of this particular prophetic word says, you are in between two men who are madly in love with you. Hallelujah. Now, this particular prophetic word is direct. It is a direct and a specific word. Now, this is not a word of beating about the bushes, but this is a word of what is happening in the life of somebody right now. And I want to talk about it. Now, you must understand one thing, that a lot is going on. And everybody wants success. Everybody wants to live an amazing life. Everybody wants to testify. Everybody wants to have a good life. You know, one thing I always tell people, but I did not used to say that before, but I started saying it when my eyes got open to a lot of things. I started saying that you only live once. So if you want to live life, you must make the fullness. You must live the fullness of your life. You must make it full time. You must make any benefits you're enjoying. You must make whatever you want to make happy. You must make it happen for you, because we only live once. You know, it is just few people who are opportune to die and then God still give them another chance, you know. So we live in a society where everybody wants to be happy. Everybody wants to have an amazing marriage. Everybody wants to have an amazing relationship. That's for people who have made up their minds, okay, to get married, to be into relationships. Everybody wants to have an amazing financial life, job, company. Like, everybody desires a good thing. I've not seen somebody who says, I want evil to happen to me. I've not seen that kind of person. I've not seen somebody who says the desire negativity, the desire evil. So everybody wants good things, but some people want better for themselves. Some people want better for their lives. Now, a lot is happening in the life of your, in the life of this particular person I'm talking about. I want to say in your life. Because if this particular prophetic word concerns you, if this particular prophetic word has to do with you, then it means you're the person I'm talking about this. So the person I'm talking about right now, a lot is happening in your life. You got to a stage where your trust became broken. I say it again. You got to a stage where your trust became broken. And because your trust became broken, you decided to give another person a try. You decided to say, okay, let me open up to this other person. Now, the old person is back again in your life. So there is the new and there is the old person. And these two men are amazingly and madly in love with you. So at this point in time, it's a problem of choice. What choice do I make? Now, the funniest aspect about this thing is you can never accept somebody back if you're not in love with them. Most of the times, people would accept their exes back, even when they have a present relationship, not because they want to be cheaters. Sometimes, for the positive aspect, is because they're still in love with this ex. So they feel like, okay, let me see if it's going to work, you know, and they're just getting to know the present person. One character about me is I don't judge people. Am I encouraging you to live that kind of life? No. I'm not encouraging you to live that kind of life. But what I'm saying is sometimes some people are vulnerable. Some people just fall into some things without knowing. Some people just behave, starts behaving a type, some kind of attitude without knowing. and they fall into regrets. So this particular person, you have the first person and you have the second person in your life. But at this juncture, you are so confused. You're confused because the problem is choice, is trust was broken with the other person, but you love this other person and this person is struggling to build back the trust. This person is struggling to make you know that they're not going to leave you. This person is struggling to make you know that they're going to stand with you. They will not disappoint you anymore. The other person, on the other hand, who came second, is amazing, is wonderful, is so kind to you. But your spec, I should say, is the first person who breaks your trust. So right now you're asking yourself, do I go to somebody who is my spec, or do I go to somebody who can take good care of me? Now, a general advice. I would prefer somebody who can take good care of me, or prefer somebody who understands me. Growing up, we always wanted our specs. Yes, God can bless you with your spec, with a good character, with somebody who can take good care of you. As well as there are people who might not be your spec, but they understand you and they can take good care of you. Everybody is likable to change. There are people who can change and there are people who cannot change. Now, this is just a general advice. But most of the times, if you ask me, I would say that time is going to expose every answer. But do you keep on being in between two people? That is where the question mark is. Time is going to reveal to you who is better. But you cannot continue to be with two people and waiting for time to reveal. When you withdraw yourself, you will see better. But while you are in between, you cannot see it. Oh, Pastor, what if I lose them? There is a way you withdraw yourself from people with wisdom. You know people's true character when you are not useful to them. That is when you know people's true character. I pray for you that let the Lord confirm this word to your spirit and let the Lord do a new thing. Give you better clarity and direction. Confirm this word to you. In Jesus' name, amen. If this word concerns you, type it in the comment section. Connect yourself, make that confession. Say, I will take the right decision as led by the Spirit of God, in the name of Jesus. God will lead you into taking the right decision. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. Please do not forget to like, share, and subscribe. And please do not forget to pray for me. God bless you in the name of Jesus, amen. Now, may the Lord bless you, keep you, cast his face to shine in you. May he be gracious to you, and may he give you peace. The shalom of the Lord, nothing missing, nothing broken. I love you so much, I do. I love you. God bless you amazingly and abundantly. Shalom.